Mission-critical files shouldn't be kept on a Synology NAS in one location. It should be stored on multiple Synology NAS in multiple locations. Stick around to find out how. It's TechWizTime. Hope you're having a productive week. My name is Jonathan and this is TechWizTime, where I create technology tutorials and review videos. If you haven't subscribed, then make sure you do and hit that bell icon too. Keeping all your eggs in one basket is a recipe for disaster. The same goes for important files. Potential losses can destroy businesses. That's where an offsite backup or mirror can be an invaluable asset to any size business. In this video, I will show you how to create a mirrored backup solution using two Synology NAS in two separate locations using the DSM package Hyper Backup. Before we go any further, this video is part of a series of Synology videos. You can see more great Synology videos above or below in the description. Full disclosure, Synology sent out these products so I could create several tutorials. No money exchanged hands. With that all said, let's get started. In this tutorial, I'll be referring to the primary Synology NAS as the source of the original files and the backup Synology NAS as the location of our backups. On the primary Synology NAS, we need to first install Hyper Backup package. Launching the Distation Manager, we need to go to the Distation Menu button and open Package Center. From the left-hand side, we need to choose the Backup section, and here you need to find Hyper Backup. Now let's click the Install button. Once that's installed, we can click on the Open button or open it directly from the main menu. Inside the Hyper Backup package, we need to choose our backup destination. We are presented with a whole range of options, including cloud storage solutions. In this tutorial, however, we are concentrating on backing up to a remote Synology NAS in a separate secure location. To achieve this, we need to choose Remote Synology NAS. The first thing we need to do here is input the IP address or server name of the backup Synology NAS. Previously, I created a video on remotely accessing a Synology NAS via the internet. I show you three different ways of setting it up depending on your circumstances. For that video, click on the iCard above or check in the description below. Once you've input those details, we need to choose if we want to encrypt the transfer. This is either an off or on option. For sensitive data, encrypting the transfer is highly recommended in the unfortunate event that traffic is being sniffed. When transferring between two Synology NAS units, the port here should be correct. In the instant that these ports have been changed, input your port number here. Otherwise, the default 6281 port can be left here. Next, we need to input the username and password for the backup Synology NAS. Once those details have been input, click the field beside Shared Folder. If the server details are correct, this should provide you with an option of where to save the backup. If you have incorrect details or if you haven't set up Hyper Backup Vault on the backup Synology NAS, you will get a failed to connect to the backup destination message, like this on the screen now. So whilst we're at it, let's install a Hyper Backup Vault on the backup Synology NAS. Log into the backup Synology NAS and in the Distation menu, we need to go to the Package Center. Here we need to choose Backup from the left side and click on the Install button for Hyper Backup Vault. Once it's installed, click on the Open button. You will see this blank screen here if everything went well. Now that's set up, we will go back to our primary Synology NAS and try clicking on the field beside the Shared Folder section. If everything is correct above, we will now be given the option to choose the destination folder on the backup Synology NAS. Next, we need to type in a directory name for our backup files. This can be left as default if you like. Click on the blue Next button to proceed to the next screen. Here we can choose the folder or multiple folders that we want to back up. Place a tick beside any folder or expand them to see a deeper folder. Once you're happy with the data backup folders, click the blue Next button. Here we are given a whole heap of options for this backup task. Firstly, we can change the name of the task. This can be left as default if you like. Next, we can choose if we want to receive notifications whenever the backup task is run. Compressing the backup data will allow for a smaller file to be transferred. This is especially useful when dealing with slower internet connections. This is where upload speed plays a role on the primary Synology NAS side, and the download speed is relevant on the backup Synology NAS side. If you're interested in learning how to load balance two internet connections with a Synology router, then click on the iCard above or find the link in the description below. Next, we have client-side encryption. This will mean the backup file will be encrypted with a password to ensure the data cannot be accessed. This is optional, but can be enabled by ticking the box. Next, we can perform this backup on a schedule. We have the option to perform this daily, on selected days, just weekends, or weekdays. Next, we can choose the time of day to run the backup. By default, this is at 3 a.m., which should suit most people. Integrity checks can help ensure data is not corrupt or missing from the backups. Just like the backup schedule, the frequency and time can be chosen to suit. Weekly, monthly, yearly, or half yearly are the options. If choosing weekly, perhaps choose a date that the device won't be in use, as an example, a Sunday morning at 5 a.m. We can impose a time limit if needed too. The default is 30 minutes, but you can input a length in minutes to suit your needs. Once done, click on the blue next button. Now we come to the rotation settings. When files are accessed and changed regularly, the chance of a file being accidentally deleted or changed are high. To ensure we can always get that file back, enable backup rotation. Here we have three options: from the earliest versions, smart recycle, or customized retention. For most people, the options of the earliest version should be fine. For a more custom rotation, the last option can be chosen and customized via the settings button. For this tutorial and for the best experience, I recommend the smart recycle option. To put it simply, smart recycle retains hourly, daily, and weekly versions intelligently, so you don't have to think too much into it. You can specify the number of versions you would like to retain before rotation occurs. 256 is the default and will be the best option for most circumstances. To learn more about smart recycle, check out the link in the description. Once you're happy with this, hit the blue apply button. This will start setting up the backup, and you will then be presented with the option to backup now. Click the blue yes button to create your initial backup right now. This will now start the backup process on the primary Synology NAS to the backup Synology NAS. If you've turned notifications on, this will appear in the notifications bubble in the top right hand corner. To check the backup was successfully transferred, log into your backup Synology NAS, and if you didn't leave the Hyper Backup Vault open, go into the disk station menu and open it now. You should see the recently completed backup here now. You can see when the last backup was completed and the duration of the backup. Up top, we can see the total space used for the backups too. Now you've got a remote Synology NAS backup scheduled to ensure your data is safely stored off-site in case of any potential data loss. How awesome is that? If you've got any suggestions for future Synology videos, then leave me a comment down below and let me know. Consider subscribing to TechWizTime to see more Synology and technology videos. Already a subscriber? Then click on that bell icon to get instant notifications of my new videos. Like and share this video if you enjoyed it, and as always, imagine, learn, create.